morning. Thank you for being with us today. Rob Bonta, California Attorney General, and grateful to be here to announce a case that we are proud to be a part of here at the California Department of Justice. We are joining the U.S. Department of Justice, and we are part of a 16-state, multi-state action of bipartisan states across the country, suing Apple for monopolistic actions and across a wide array of behaviors. And I do first want to note that it is not super frequent and often that we have bipartisan multi-state actions. I think it speaks volumes about the concern of the conduct at issue here. And we're pleased to be working closely with our U.S. Department of Justice on this action and eager to get into court, make our case, and prove them up. And we filed earlier today in district court in the District of New Jersey. Our complaint is essentially four causes of action, all arising out of the allegation under federal antitrust law that Apple is engaged in monopolistic behavior, and over two potential markets, the performance smartphone market and the smartphone market, and we allege monopolistic behavior and attempted monopolistic behavior. And we allege that these this behavior has been ongoing for essentially 15 years plus, and that Apple has, as an image we like to use to explain the concept here, created a moat around its kingdom and trapped customers into continuing to use iPhones and buying more iPhones, which are the leading revenue driver in Apple's business model, and keeping out other types of technologies or services that could provide a better user experience, and that they are not the leading the leader in the market that they are because they are winning on the merits. They are in that place, in that front position, because of illegal monopolistic behaviors. So our job is to make sure that the market is free, that the rules are followed, the laws are followed, that a entity like Apple, who has a $3-plus trillion market cap, is not using that market power in a way that's unfair and unlawful. They are. It needs to stop, and our complaint seeks injunctive relief, ending of the illegal behavior, so that they change their behavior to comply with existing law. If they do, when they do, it will help increase competition, increase innovation, improve quality, lower prices. It'll be a great benefit for consumers. So that is the heart of our case. We look forward to presenting our case in court. I do want to say thank you to my team who got us here, a great team that's been working on a number of antitrust cases in the tech space, but in others as well, including the airline industry and agricultural industry and others. I want to thank senior legal analyst Laura Namba, as well as Ivan Zogovich, and Ivan is here, Deputy Attorneys General Kari Jeffries, Brian Wang, Robert McNary. Robert's here today. Thank you, Robert. And Supervising Deputy Attorney General Michael Jorgensen, Senior Assistant Attorney General Paula Blizzard, and Special Assistant Attorney General Ellie Bloom, who is right here. So we have a great team. We're proud to announce our participation in this case, the filing of this lawsuit against Apple. I do want to say that this is a pro-business action. When we make sure that the rules of the marketplace are being followed, that no one is acting illegally, abusing their power, acting in a way that's anti-competitive or exclusionary, it provides an opportunity for the next innovator, the next dreamer, the next visionary, the next startup, the next mom and pop, to be able to participate in the marketplace and compete, as opposed to being squashed out and pushed out because of the dominant market force of the leading entity. So Apple has time and time again gone out of its way to make it difficult for certain products and services and features to be used on their phone. This is not just that they have done nothing and have been indifferent. They have actively, and as part of a design where an approach that we have heard directly from, you know, former CEO Steve Jobs about, locked in their customers, kept competition and better quality services out, and made their Apple ecosystem, as they call it, sticky, making customers, forcing them to stay within the ecosystem. And we talk about that in a number of ways in our complaint, this sticky ecosystem. And it applies to a number of different features that are being used. Some are a little bit more easy to understand from the everyday persons. I'm sure we have a lot of iPhone users in this room, Apple customers in this room and throughout the state, certainly. But the first is in messaging. Many of you are aware of the green versus the blue bubbles. And for those who use an iPhone and use the iPhone messaging tool, and you're speaking to someone else who uses the iPhone messaging tool, you have a full variety and plethora of features. You get the photo comes through with full pixels, and you're able to use the emojis and the thumbs ups and thumbs downs. But when you're talking to someone who doesn't use an iPhone, who uses a Samsung or a Google, those features are deliberately degraded. The quality is worse by design on purpose to make those who have a Samsung or Google phone to reconsider whether they should have that. If they want the full features, maybe they should have an iPhone too. And we see this particularly when it comes to young people in group chats. There is a peer pressure for the one individual who's not on an iPhone to consider having an iPhone to keep the quality of that ongoing group chat at the highest level. So I think that's something that most people can identify with. We've all, or many of us, have experienced that deliberately degraded functionality and quality that Apple has gone out of its way in order to create the sticky ecosystem as part of its ongoing monopolistic behavior. The second is super apps. This is maybe something that's not as well known because super apps have been, for the most part, successfully kept out of the performance smartphone and smartphone markets by Apple. And these are platforms that have mini apps within them. You can have your email, your messaging, your favorite games, all within a super app. WeChat is one of them, although it's degraded in its use here in the United States. The way it operates overseas shows sort of what the super app tool looks like. And a super app would allow a user to use the super app across different phones, across different platforms, in an iPhone, with a Samsung, with a Google phone. Apple has, again, deliberately and aggressively gone out of its way to prevent the use of super apps, which would be a great pro-consumer asset and tool. There's also something called cloud gaming as a third example that we lift up in our complaint. Where a lot of the processing for the game is done in the cloud, and you don't need to have significant processing capacity on the iPhone itself. You could use a less expensive phone, a phone with less processing ability, and with the processing of the gaming being done in the cloud, enjoy the full experience of the game. Because Apple saw that as a challenge to their marketplace, they have kept these cloud games off of their iPhone for the most part. There has been some recent change, which we think is due to the pressure and the growing awareness of this conduct. Smartwatches, fourth example of the five I'm going to discuss today. Apple has restricted the compatibility of the smartwatches, the Apple smartwatches, to be only used with iPhones. They are not compatible with non-Apple phones, and non-Apple watches are not compatible with iPhones. So, they, again, the sticky ecosystem where you can only use certain products with Apple iPhones, reducing consumer choice, reducing and deteriorating consumer experience. And then finally, digital wallets. The tap-to-pay functionality is something that is only provided by the Apple Pay product on the iPhone. Again, the best features, the most robust ability, the convenience, the pro-consumer experience is restricted deliberately only to Apple products and other digital wallets. For example, if another bank created a digital wallet or pay system, those are either excluded or the quality and the performance is deliberately degraded and deteriorated. So these are some of the issues that we're getting at with the complaint. Again, this is a major complaint, a major antitrust action taken by none other than the U.S. DOJ, the California DOJ, the largest state Department of Justice in the nation, multiple states working together. We do expect that potentially other departments of justice from other states could join as we go forward. But we're making a powerful statement about the need to follow the law and to not act in anti-competitive ways, in exclusionary ways, to not abuse your monopoly position, your market power, and to participate in the marketplace on the merits. Provide the best product, be the most innovative, provide the best user experience. That's how you should prevail in the marketplace, not by deliberately keeping from consumers better experiences or deliberately degrading their experience when they use non-Apple products, features, apps, or services. So so many of us these days, because of the incredible market share that Apple has, we use our iPhones. Nearly 90% of iPhone owners in the U.S. Continue to use iPhones, and they replace their iPhone with another iPhone. Apple dominates the market in the performance smartphone market with more than 70% of that market and 65% of the broader smartphone market share. More than 50% of smartphones sold in the U.S. are iPhones, and nearly 90% of teenagers own an iPhone. So all that is to say that iPhone, as we all know from our own lived experience, is ubiquitous. We use it to do so many daily activities, to share photos, conduct business, navigate the roads when we're driving, buy our groceries, go to the bank, how we read, watch, and listen to news or entertainment. It should be a free and open marketplace with the best quality. It should not be manipulated with anti-competitive or exclusionary practices. We need to make sure that consumers and competition in a fair market exist, and that's what this lawsuit is about. It is pro-consumer, it is pro-business, it is anti-monopoly, anti-manipulation, and we're grateful for the opportunity to join the US DOJ and 15 other states in bringing this case. This is very consistent with the work that we've been doing, holding many entities accountable when they engage in anti-competitive conduct, and we will continue as the Department of Justice in the nation with the most robust set of resources the best antitrust team, if I do say so myself. We will continue our action. This is another example of it.